If someone wanted a telescope before the 20th century, chances are that they had to make one by themselves, as commercial telescopes were expensive. If someone could afford to buy a telescope, the choice to buy one was easy, as one type of telescope predominated. It was likely a small refractor telescope of 2 to 3 inch in aperture, similar to the type of telescope that Galileo used, in which the light coming from a celestial object arrives in rays that are perfectly parallel and refracts through a front lens called an objective lens, similar to the lens of a magnifying glass, which converges the light to form an image at its focal point. But our eyes cannot see this image, as the converged light at the focal point is not parallel, because the lens inside our eyes is designed to focus parallel rays to form an image on the retina. So we need one more lens that catches the light as it diverges away from the focal point and bends it back to a parallel rays, so that our eyes can refocus it on the retina to form an image that we actually see. The small second lens is called an eyepiece lens, as it processes the light so that our eye can see. In this process, notice how the telescope has taken all the light passing through the objective lens and compressed it down to a column of light that will pass through the pupil of the eye. Doing so, it is collecting way more light than our eyes to make a bright image, resolving more details in the image than our eye can see, and finally, treating us with a magnified image so we can see the additional details of an object of interest. All this can be achieved by just putting an objective lens similar to a magnifying glass and a smaller eyepiece lens together in a tube properly to make it into a telescope. That's pretty simple, right? But at this point, you might be thinking, why can't we just point magnifying glass towards the sky and observe celestial objects just like we magnify a text on a paper? Well, if you look at the lens of a magnifying glass, it's made of biconvex lens. That's part of two spherical lenses put together. When non-parallel diverged light coming from a closer object enters the lens from one side, then it gives off parallel rays on the other side that can be focused by our eyes, giving a magnified view of a part of the object close to its optical center. But when parallel light from faraway objects enters into this lens from one side, it converges on the other side at its focal point, giving a blurred image. That is why a single magnifying glass is not suitable for looking at celestial objects. To do so, we need an extra lens such as an eyepiece to convert into a telescope, as we discussed before.